Hello, and welcome to another episode of 5 Minutes with Franza. I'm your host, Dr. Thomas Franza. In this episode, I'm going to be showing you how to configure Microsoft Outlook so that you can use it on your home machine. It's really straightforward and simple, providing that your network administrator or your email administrator has configured on Exchange a piece that's like an auto-discover. So what happens is that when you put in your information, it's going to fill it. Now, you can do it with manual, and it takes a little bit more time, but then you're going to need to talk to your email administrator because they're going to need to give you the special settings to put in. So we're going to make the assumption for this video that the auto-configure is set up properly, and you'll see how easy it is. It's not even going to take 5 minutes, so let's begin.
Now, before you start Microsoft Outlook, if this was one of those times where you just installed Office, okay, and you're so excited to get to your email, you want to jump into Outlook, don't. What you want to do is you want to just run Office once. And when I say Office, I mean Word or Excel, PowerPoint, anything other than Outlook. The reason being is that what you want to do is you need to get Office configured. And Office configures itself when you run Word. So run Word at least once, and what'll happen is that you'll get the thing and it'll ask you about the automatic updates and all that other happy stuff. Your initials. Once you do that, you can close Word. Now you're good to go. Now all you have to do is go on over and navigate to Microsoft Office 2013. Find where it says Outlook 2013 or 2010. And the first time you start, it's going to ask you for a profile. So in this case, I'm going to create one called HCC. It stands for Harford Community College, where I work. And we say okay. Okay, ask for your email account. So in this case, I want to call it Tom Franza. Email address. You just enter your email address. It helps if you can spell. And put in the password. This is the password that you use for to get into your email. Retype it in, and that's pretty much it. Now, sometimes you won't have this auto-configure set up. In that case, you'll have to go for the manual settings. When you go for the manual settings, you're going to need additional information that's going to be provided by your email or network administrator. But in this case, you put in your name. Other silly mistake that people make is when they put in their email address, they leave off at the @ and the organizational name. So make sure you don't forget that. Just say next. It's going to say establishing a network connection. It's going to search to see if I exist. I have to restart Outlook. It may or may not ask you to do that. I say okay, and we just let it go. And there you go. See, I've established a network connection. It searched for me, it found me, and it logged me in. If you have a problem, here's the key. Look at the arrow checks, because depending on where you get down, depends on where the problem is. If I didn't make it to establishing a network connection, I may not be on the internet. So, silly, go fix it. Searching for tfranz@harford.edu. If I don't exist on the server because I misspelled my email address, or maybe I put in, I would probably not get a connection here, or if the auto configure is not set properly. Last but not least, you would check here for logging on to the mail server. If this doesn't check off, you probably mistyped your password. But again, when you're calling the help desk for support, this information helps. Let them know how far you got. In this case, congratulations, it worked. If I had another email account that I wanted to add to this, I could add it at this time. But for now, I'm just going to be good and I'm going to say finish. And that's about it. Outlook is configured. It is that simple. If you're a network administrator watching this or an email administrator and you want to know how to set up the auto-configure, that's beyond my abilities. You're going to need to reach out and get professional help. But other than that, that's it. Microsoft Outlook is configured. It did not even take 5 minutes. I hope you found this episode of 5 Minutes with Franza helpful. Once again, I'm your host, Dr. Thomas Franza, and thank you for watching.